Over to you, Kellie Raspberry.
Thank you, Cannon. I was having lunch with a couple of friends yesterday when a nice man creeped up alongside of our booth, looked at me with wide eyes and a huge smile and asked, "Aren't you?" And before I could say, "Why, yes, I am," he said, "Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were my friend Catherine." So I said, "Well, Catherine must be gorgeous. Please tell her I said hello." And he laughed and agreed she was, apologized for the interruption, and then went back to his table. So after a few minutes, the man came back and said he was an Episcopal priest and felt like he needed to ask me, "Is there something I can pray for you?"
Wow. Whoa!
And I said, "As a matter of fact, yes." I told him what I'd already revealed on stereo, and y'all really should have tuned in because you would have already known this, but I'll tell the rest of you now. My daughter wants to go live with her dad.
Aww.
And this has been just tearing me up. Yeah. And it's not that we're at each other's throats. We're not, you know, it's not like we're screaming and slamming doors and she's threatening, "I want to go live with dad." Mm-hmm. She just wants to go to the school in his district. That's all it is.
Really?
Yeah. Still, though.
And my heart is just crushed. It's looking like, you know, she's been making all of the reasonable arguments as to why she wants this to happen, and I feel like I should let her. So I asked the preacher man to pray for me about that, so he took my hand, and he did, and then he tipped his hat and left me to finish my salad. But if any of y'all are praying people, if there's any room on your prayer list, I'd appreciate it if you put me at the bottom and include me right now, because this is hard.
Oh, I'm sorry, Kellie.
It's just heartbreaking.
Yeah. It sucks.
I'm sorry. Babe.
But, now, you know, it's not like her dad's a bad person and she's going to a bad environment. I love her stepmom. She's a great stepmom to her, so it's good, but it's just like, dang it, I thought I had, you know, she's going to be going into the ninth grade. I was like, I'm not really prepared to lose her yet. But even though, I'll be able to get her on weekends and stuff. Mm-hmm. It's just role reversal.
And what could happen, and I've seen this happen in situations like the one you have, Kellie, where the kid wants to go live at the dad's house or the mom's house and they were staying with the other. And then she'll go for a year and then she'll realize, you know what?
Kellie ain't so bad.
It's not the school.
It's the school. I want to go back to my friends at that school. Maybe it'll be a 1 year thing and she'll come back. Maybe she won't, but at least it's showing you that she's willing to try new things and spread her wings. That's cool.
It's incredibly brave and shows she's got some confidence in her to go, I can go restart my whole life and show everybody how cool I am at this whole new school, because it is a scary situation at a new school. Yeah. And showing that she wants to do that, that shows that she's got a good mom raising her.
What a good spin. Good spin, Trey. Yeah.